Hello and welcome to our series of learning videos about our TDM software MwPharm++. The topic for this video is how to dose the drug in dosing tab. So, let us begin with this tab. On this page, you can see the same graph as the simulation tab and fitting tab. In the profile section, you can change the doses. You can insert a dose to the column user that you want. To the row load, insert loading dose in milligrams. This dose must be high enough to get an initial concentration of zero between the minimal and maximal concentration. Loading dose is larger than the maintenance dose. To the row dose, insert maintenance dose in milligrams. To the T-in, insert time interval between the doses, and to the end dose, insert number of doses. If you will be dosing as infusion, you must insert infusion duration. For displaying the graph with user dose, you must tick off here. Column exact will suggest the most appropriate dosage, which in practice cannot be used. Exact dosing ignores the real size of the tablets and dosage time is very impossible to follow. This exact dosage cannot be changed. The columns from P1 to P4 means practice. These doses are possible to use in practice. They are calculated according to the size of available individual doses of medicines. These sizes of medications must be entered by yourself according to the available information in SPC. If you give your cursor on the small triangle here, you will be offered the help about profile section. Here is the help about target section. On the right side, you can see the bar graph. The red column is your own dosage. The black column is a simulation with the exact dosages. Blue columns are the practice dosages. If you want to select dosing of a patient, it's the best to choose dosing in a bar chart, which goes slightly above the minimum and ends slightly below the maximum. In the target section, you can change the maximum and minimum only in this patient and only in this drug. After switching, you can see maximum, minimum, and also average in the graphs above. If you want to activate the AUC mode normalized to 24 hours, select this. Select the log scale and thereby switch the logarithmic scale on your graphs. If you activate user reference mode, you can manually propose own dosages. In the road section, you can choose what type of drug administration you want to use, if it is available for the used drug. In the reference section, you will see what is your target object. In the method section, you can choose different kind of load. I recommend you leave here the optimal setting. This setting will keep the concentration at an optimum concentration values. If you choose the auto, concentrations are automatically recalculated. If you choose minimum or maximum, concentration will approach rather to the minimum or maximum value. In this section, you can also influence the size of the dose. If you want to keep concentration in the patient's body to a minimum and maximum, select this. If you want to keep concentration in the patient's body around the average value, select this. Sometimes it is necessary that the concentration in the body of the patient was calculated rather than the maximum average and a patient stay away to the minimum. In this case, select this. When you want to hold the concentration in the patient's body at the minimum concentration, choose this. If you select AUC, the dose will be adjusted to the area under the curve value for 24 hours. If you click the button Add to History, your dosage that you entered here will be reflected in the History tab. This function calculates the exact dosage and period between doses, so that the concentration was again between the desired maximum and minimum values. This function is useful in case you have an overdose patient. You do not try to find out how much is needed to reduce the dose, because you will know the new dose immediately. That is all for today's lesson. Thanks for watching and see you in the next part, where I will explain the users, settings, help, and about tabs. Bye!